I would like to begin this week's episode with an apology. It has been brought to my attention that in the first episode, I was not clear with my instructions on which page each of the drawings was meant to go on. As a teacher, it is my duty and responsibility to be as clear as possible with all of my instructions. I apologize for this. The reason that I didn't tell you that is because I forgot. I told you guys, I have an old and crotchety brain. I forget things. It's also been brought to my attention that some of you noticed that the garbage gobbler that I show at the end of episode 2 is different from the garbage gobbler that I'm drawing in the top-down view of the camera. The reason for this is that the camera ran out halfway through filming and I had to reshoot the entire thing and draw an entirely new garbage gobbler so that I could release the video on time. And I thought I was going to get away with it. And I would have gotten away with it too, but some of you are just a little bit too observant, aren't you? Like observing things, eh? Well, I've got a challenge for you. In this video, I'm going to change things around 5 times. Try and see if you can notice each time I change it. Good luck! Let's finish our book! Before we get into finishing our book, I just want to take a moment and say thank you for sending in all the pictures that you've done over the past few weeks. Oh my goodness, they are so good! I mean, just have a look at them. The thing I love most about these is that each one has its own unique style and own unique vision. Ah, I can tell you guys had so much fun doing these. I'll show more pictures at the end of the episode. Let's get back to our book. Right, we're going to do our cover today. Remember when we folded this? All the way back in episode 1. Good times. Hope you still have it. If you don't, doesn't matter. Just fold another piece of paper. Or I've noticed some of you have just been doing the pictures in loose pieces of paper. That's totally fine too. All right, so let's get our cover. We're gonna break our cover up into 3 parts. We're going to draw the outside cover, the inside cover, and the inside back cover. All right. Let's get started with our cover. I'm going to call my book The Creatures Inside My House. You may want to call it something different, but that's the title that I'm going to go with. We're going to do a few different things on the cover. Again, this is just an idea. This is what I want to do. If you want to follow along, that's great. But if you want to take it in a completely different direction, by all means, go for it. But I am going to first stretch out my cover because I'm going to draw the whole thing. I'm going to draw my title. And I'm going to do part of it inside a house, and I'm going to draw the characters on the front of the book, but I'm going to do them in silhouette. Now, silhouette means that I'm going to do them as like an outline of the shape, and then fill it in black, kind of like the shadow version of these characters. The reason I'm going to do it in silhouette is to create a kind of a sense of mystery and intrigue. People will see the cover, and they'll see the creatures that are inside the book, but they won't see what they actually look like. They'll just see the shape of them, and that will make them want to flip through the pages and see what they look like. So, I'm going to start my cover with a line, which is going to be the ground that I'm going to put my house on. Like that. Then I'm going to use one of the techniques that we've learned. I'm going to write the creatures like that. I'm going to do a banner. So remember, do the banner, we do 2 lines to box the letters in. Join them up at the end there. S and now M, S, now M on that side, collide that in. Now I'm going to draw the house. Now I'm going to keep the house very, very simple, just down to 2 shapes, the triangle for the roof and a box for the house itself. So I'm going to start with the triangle and I'm going to make it look like it's behind the banner. So I'll start the top of the triangle up here. Continue it down like this. And then I'll continue the box down like that. I'm going to write in my there. House. Right there. Makes it look a little bit fun. I'm going to do a simple little box for the door. And I'm going to do some windows. And I might do arch windows. Because everyone knows that the arch window is the best. We all watch Play School, right? The arch window was the best. And underneath that, I'm going to put my name so everyone knows who this book is by. By Aaron McKenna. Okay, onto the shapes of our characters. Let's start with Bomber. Now, if we have a look at him, his shapes are circle, kind of a jelly bean down the bottom, wiggly eyes, pointy hat with a bobble, and some wavy hair in the ears. All right, so if I try and do his silhouette, I'll do a circle for his head, put his ears on the side, triangle for the hat, circle there, that's his body, and then we'll do some wiggly arms like that, and his hair on the side like that. Okay, now we just fill him in. We've got our first silhouette. Garbage Gobbler next. He was just like a nice big blob. So we'll do him as a big blob with his little stubby arms there. He's an easy one. Fill him in. You can take more time. I'm trying to do this quickly so the episode doesn't run too long. Messina's next. She had an oval head and her wavy trunk body. With her wavy legs, like the root of a tree, branchy arms, there we go, messy hair, and we'll put a little bird on the side there, make that a triangle with a beak, and some feathers, colour that in. Too easy. Last we'll do Zelda. Now Zelda had a few more shapes involved. I'll put her there. So she had the triangle, the line for the hat, circle for the head, sort of box for the body, big round dress there. So we'll start with the circle. So we'll start with the triangle for her hat. Draw that in. Do her head like that. We might want to put in a little bit of her hair just so that it's distinguishable. We've got her body down like that, and then we'll do her dress, which goes over like this with the jagged edges, her pointy little feet like that, and her arms that go like this, the kind of spiky claw hands that I imagine a witch would have. Alright. We filled her in. Let's do a cauldron as well. So that was just a simple circle for the top, circle for the bottom with the two little legs. There we go. So we've done all the creatures on the cover. Anyone that picks this book up is going to be like, ooh, I wonder what they really look like. They're really going to want to open up the page. But the cover's looking a little bit bare, so I'm going to fill in the background with a few little things. Not just going to keep it simple for today. I'm going to draw some bushes. And they're just simple bumps. They kind of fill in the background. Like that. And I might put some clouds up the top. And clouds can just go like line for the bottom. And then some different bumps when you draw a cloud, so you want to try to keep the bumps a different size, because you don't want them all looking the same. Just creates a nice little bit of variation. You can see those two kind of look the same, but that's okay. All right, we've got a pretty spiffy looking cover. Let's move on to the inside cover now. Now for the inside cover, I'm gonna draw a map of my house and I'm gonna use it as a kind of contents page. Now you probably come across a contents page in a book before, but that's where you list what's inside your book with page numbers that tell people where they can go to find whatever they wanna find. In this instance, I'm going to draw a map of my house and I'm going to put a number where each of the creatures live. So anyone that opens up my book can look and know which page to turn to see which creature lives in that area of my house. Now, let's start with how we're going to draw our house. Now, there's a couple of ways you can do your map. You could do it as if you were looking down on top of your house and draw from the top down, or you can do it from the side. So it's almost like your house is split in two. That's what I'm gonna do because I have a two-level house and I wanna use both levels. So I'm gonna do my map as if we're looking outside and we've cut my house in half. So you might wanna take some time, have a wander around your house, have a look at it, and think about how you wanna draw the map of your house. And we'll keep this simple as well, just simple, simple shapes. So I'll start with my roof, which is kind of a slanty box shape. And then I'll do the box for my house, line for the ground, and then I'm gonna do two kind of circles down here with some steps out to our garden. Let's start with my garden. I'm just gonna draw some, again, just some simple little bumpy shapes to make it look like the bushes in our garden. Moving back up to the house, I'm going to draw a line for the first floor and the second floor. A line to show the different rooms down the bottom. Here we go. And now we'll fill in the rooms. So the top of the house is the kitchen. So that's where the garbage gobbler lives. So I'm going to draw my kitchen bench. Put a top on it, draw a tap, because that's where the tap is, and I might just do a little bench here to show the cupboards. Notice I'm just using simple shapes, keep it nice and simple. Then we've got our bedroom here, so I'm going to draw bed, the pillow, some sheets there. Just put a little door in there too. Why not? Downstairs, we have our rumpus room. So that's where our couch is. So I'll draw our couch. That's where our TV is too. So I'll draw our TV. And the shelf where we keep all our games and toys and books and things. In this room, that's just another bedroom, so I'll draw just another bed there. Okay, that's the map of my house. Now, I have to think about where each of the creatures are going to go. So I've put numbers on the bottom of each of my pages here. So you'll see 1, 2, 3, and I'm busted again. I couldn't find the original book when I filmed the Messina episode, so Messina was drawn on a separate piece of paper. You'll probably notice that that's different as well in that episode. And so in this instance, I've just put her in a single sheet of paper into my book. And number 4 for Zelda. So for number 1, for Bomba, I think he likes to hide in our rumpus. So I'm going to draw a 1 in the rumpus, put a nice circle around it. Number 2. Garbage gobbler. Well, he's under the sink, so that's easy. 3 for Messina. She's out in the backyard. And 4 for Zelda, because she's up in the roof. Okay. And that's our contents page done. Only thing left is to do the inside back cover. Now for the back inside cover, we're going to have a little bit of fun and we're going to do an author's page. You may have noticed an author's page in books before. It's usually where there's a picture of the author and a couple of words written about them, usually with their name and what they've done in the past and what they like. So let's do that for us. All right, let's start with the box. And I'm going to draw a picture of myself. So I'm going to do a round head. Squares for glasses. I might just rub out a little bit of the head there. Put my eyes in. Just dots. Nose. Do my beard, which is very long and scraggly at the moment. Give myself a smile. And my hair, which is also very long at the moment. Neck and just a simple little body. You might want to do a full body picture in yours. Like always, go crazy. Do whatever you feel. Do whatever feel best expresses you as a person and an author, because that's what you are now. All right, I'm gonna put my name next to that. And I'm gonna write a few little things about what I like. Aaron likes comics and cartoons. He likes eating pizza. And he loves watching small dogs walk fast. Because it's funny, isn't it? Have you ever watched a small dog walk really fast? It's hilarious. Their little legs go and they've always got a really serious expression on their face. Trust me, it's hilarious. And that's it. We've done our author page. Our book's finished. What are we gonna do now? We're gonna put it all together. Now, there's a few different ways you can do this. You can use a stapler if you have one, and you can staple the sides to keep your book together, like that. If you have a longer stapler, you might be able to, you might be able to staple the middle like that. My one's not quite long enough for that. You might want to use some sticky tape, or you might want to do what I'm going to do. And that's just leave mine loose. Because I have a few blank sheets in my book left. So I think I'm going to do some more creatures and then put their numbers in the contents page. So by all means, this book is not finished, and yours doesn't have to be finished either. If you want to fold up some pages and add some more creatures, be my guest, be your guest, go as much as you want. But unfortunately, this is where our book adventure ends, because this is the end of this Book Week series that went for longer than Book Week did. But I hope you had a lot of fun watching the videos. I certainly had a lot of fun making them. There will be more. I'm planning on dropping them on Thursday afternoons. So like and subscribe and all that kind of stuff. I think Thursday afternoons is a good time. You know, nearly the end of the school week, it'll be something to look forward to. And then, boom, you'll get a drawing class from me. So, yeah, stay tuned for that. Until then, stay safe. Yeah, I'll see you soon. And keep drawing every day.